Through the Adobo Nation Chika series, we get to know the Filipino communities in Southern California and the New York Tri-State area. Mm-hmm. But do we really know kung paano nagsimula ang ating mga Kanations sa New York City? Do you?
No.
Well, there's a new book that chronicles the influx of Pinoys into New York from the time of Jose Rizal, Tumishi, that's Uncle Jose.
Uy, si Lolo.
Uncle Joe. And the Spanish-American War. Let's join our New York Chica girl as she digs into this significant part of Phil-Am history. Monet, Chica mo na.
Hello there, mga Kanation. I'm Monet po, and we're on to get to know some of the facts, faces, and places that kicked off our history in this amazing city. So join me po in this beautiful spring day dito lang sa NYC, Chica in the City. How would you describe po the Filipinos here in New York City?
Naku, napaka-bibo ng mga Pilipino rito. It's like, we were very close kasi okay. It's easy to get to each other. There's the train 24/7.
It's a vibrant, phenomenal culture and history that we have here. And it's something that is great to share with from generation to generation.
Talented, for sure. Like singers, dancers, artists, culturally proud.
The book Filipinos in New York City was recently published. It chronicles the periods or waves of immigration of Pinoys to New York. We learned that one of the very first Filipinos known to visit New York City was Jose Rizal. Sasamahan tayo ngayong araw ng author ng Filipinos in New York City na si Dr. Kevin Nadal.
This area is significant because this is Madison Square Park. In 1888, Jose Rizal stayed at the Fifth Avenue Hotel, which used to be over here, has now been replaced by a more modern building. But he stayed here for about a week in 1888, and so he's documented as the first Filipino to be here in New York City. Pensionados, or the students who came from the Philippines to study and learn a little bit from American education, they came to places like New York University and Columbia University to study. Some students came as early as 1900s. So this is Columbia University, the only Ivy League university here in New York City, in the heart of Harlem on 116th Street. One famous Filipino that came during this time was Carlos Romulo. He was a political leader, and he eventually became the head of the United Nations in the 1940s.
After both World Wars I and II, Filipinos arrived in New York as military servicemen and Navy seafarers, followed by the nurses, physicians, engineers in 1965, when the Immigration and Nationality Act made it easy for skilled Filipino laborers to enter the United States. With the help of the Filipino community and the Filipino-American National Historical Society, Dr. Nadal collected more than 200 images for the book. And each photo has a gripping story to tell us all.
A lot of the inspiration came from the individuals that were interested in fawns to begin with. And it turned out that they had already documented and kept a lot of these very important details about their families.
The adventure was looking for the pictures, looking through the pictures. I think we originally had, you know, call for photos and a contest where they chose my mother's picture as the best in show. So, and then, you know, Kevin picked it for the cover. So that was a big honor.
Always remember that our history was the beginnings of what we are now. They will not forget that they are Filipinos. Uh-huh. And they should remember all of the traditions and practices.
The future is bright for Filipino Americans. Filipino Americans are immigrating to the United States in record numbers in present day, and a lot of them are even immigrating to New York. We also have lots of Filipinos from all over the country who are transplanting themselves to New York in search of the American dream. Filipinos come here for graduate school, some come here to pursue their Broadway dreams, their musical dreams, their artistry dreams. And so it really is the place where people's dreams can come true.